Mae yn blesur i mi eich anerch heddiw, nid o goridorau tywyll San Steffan, ond o harddwch Morfyn Efyn. Does un man yn debyg i adre, meddyn nhw. Mae'r flwyddyn ddetha di amlygu ystyr y dywediad hwn mwy nag erioed. Trwy wneud yn ei werthfarogi pwysigrwydd cael catre clud a chymunedau clos, un iechyd ac un ysbryd ac un lles. Pan dan ni'n meddwl am y teimlad o fod adre, dan ni'n teimlo yn gyfforddus ac yn ddiogel. Pan mae'n sefyllfa frawychus, mae meddwl am adre yn dod â chysur. I'r rai sydd heb gartre, mae'r gair yn dod ag ysfa am ddyfodol gwell. I mi, mae bod yn rhan o Blaid Cymru yn rhoi'r teimlad i mi o fod adre. Does dim ots lle dwi, ond yn ystod y pandemig, mae'r gallu gadw mae'n cysylltu gyda'n cyd-aelodau i drafod a rannu syniadau di bod yn donig i mi. Diolch yn fawr i chi gyd. Ond i nifer yn ystod y pandemig, mae'r syniad o adre wedi chwalu gan Covid. Mae adre petlach yn dod â theimladau o unigedd, o ofyn ac yn sicrwydd. Mae miloedd o alwydydd wedi dioddau galar a phoen, salwch a cholled. Heddiw, rwy'n gobeithio bydd dod at yn gilydd yn rhithiol, yn dod â'r teimlad yna o ddod adre yn ôl. A'n tasg ni, gyda'n gilydd, yw sicrhau bod lle ar aelwyd Plaid Cymru i bawb sy'n credu yng Nghymru. Mae drws yn catre ni ar agor. Mae'r aelwyd yn croesawu pawb sydd am glosio at yn gwerthoedd. Plaid Cymru offers a welcome to all those people who believe in Wales. A home to anyone who believes we're strong enough, big enough, clever enough to make our nation a better place to live. The election we face in a matter of weeks will be unlike any other we've ever fought. We're emerging from a health disaster of proportions that we've never seen. It's a mass casualty incident that has seen the worst civilian loss of life since World War II, and that by a long way. 67,635 civilians were killed in air raids on Britain. 984 of them were in Wales. But over 120,000 lives have already been taken by the coronavirus pandemic, over 5,000 of whom, tragically, were in Wales. This is all the more heartbreaking considering we were once told that 20,000 deaths would be a good outcome, although how could that be a good outcome? Each of those 120,000 deaths was avoidable. It's not the result of bad luck. It is the consequence of the catastrophic political choices by a negligent Tory government in Westminster with the Chancellor-in-Chief at the helm. When experts were warning of an oncoming pandemic, Prime Minister Johnson was boasting on television about shaking hands with COVID patients in a hospital. International borders were unmonitored for months. He undermined his own government's authority by refusing to dismiss Dominic Cummings, his chief advisor, for breaking his very own rules. And still, despite all this, the Welsh Conservatives are still calling for a one-nation approach. They see the party's mismanagement in England and beg to be subjected to the same chaos here in Wales. And to that we say, dim diolch. Some Tory candidates for the upcoming election have blithely promised to abolish Welsh democracy. Moderate pro-devolution candidates were unceremoniously ditched in favour of an array of Boris Johnson groupies. The days when the Conservative Party could credibly claim to be the pro-devolution party are long gone. The endeavours of moderate Tories to turn the party into a pro-devolution force since 1999 have been abandoned since 2016. It's clear there's no longer any welcome for those who believe in Wales within the Conservative Party. This is the party of Westminster knows best, with its eyes set on cutting down the green shoots of self-sufficiency and self-confidence here in Wales. So what does that mean for May's Senedd election? Given the Tory party's animosity towards our parliament, it's clear that it can no longer make a credible claim to aspire to be a party of government here in Wales. Any party that fails to grant the institution any degree of respect surely cannot be trusted at its helm. How can you trust the captain who was sworn to scupper his ship of state? It is perfect to say that the Tory Conservative Party has now become an English nationalist party. These are not my words, but the words of the former Tory MP for Aberconwy. Are we content to be governed by a party intent on mocking and undermining all Welsh aspirations? Are we content to see our young democracy bulldozed by Boris Johnson? Of course we're not. If only we're all in the same room, he would hear Wales's thunder roar. Our nation is more confident than ever. The choice in this election is simple. If you believe in Wales, vote for Wales. But where does Labour fit into this? With their leader in London draping himself in the omnipresent Union Jack, Labour is a party which will always put its allegiance to the Union above everything else, even when faced with the Tories' disastrous mishandling of the pandemic. Where is the anger at the Tories' pandemic cronyism, billions of pounds of public contracts awarded to the Tories' friends, then unlawfully hidden from the public? And Labour choose to stay silent. That isn't leadership. That's hiding in the shadows until the storm has blown over. Where is the scrutiny of the damaging trade deal that's ruining the livelihoods of so many small businesses, of farmers, of fishermen and women? Where is the passion for standing up for what's right, regardless of whether it's politically convenient? And where is the confidence of our own government in our own people? Our Labour First Minister says that the temporary failure of the current occupants of power at Westminster to be an engine of distribution should not lead us to conclude that the system is incapable of delivering what is in Wales' interest. His own words are insufficient. But this isn't a temporary failure. Red and blue Westminster governments have let Wales down time and time again. We mustn't forget that Labour voted with the Conservative Westminster government to impose austerity, that Labour worked with the Conservatives to reject Plaid Cymru calls for Wales to receive fair funding in HS2, leading to Wales losing out on £5 billion of funding. Wales will lose 8 MPs in the next Westminster election. Our ability to effect change and even carry out scrutiny in London will be hampered even more. We shouldn't have to wait for a fantasy victory under a political system that is fundamentally stacked against us. We need the confidence to build our own future, regardless of what happens next door. We need a government that is driven by values and by convictions, not held back by a spineless reticence to oppose the Conservatives on just about anything, and a morbid obsession with protecting the status quo, even when that is at the expense of the well-being of the people of Wales. We need a party of government that stands up to the Tories' attacks on devolved powers, a party that won't sit on its hands faced with assaults on human rights and civil liberties. After the experience of the past year, we need a new way of thinking, a new way of working and a new way of governing. We know that countries with smaller populations, closed communities and well-funded public services have fared well in the pandemic. But still Labour opts to keep Wales shackled to Westminster. Labour was once a party for Wales, a party proud to stand up for values many of us in Wales hold dear. But now, with a leader who can't bring himself to criticise the most destructive government in living memory, not on COVID or on Brexit, the official opposition has abdicated its responsibility in the name of political convenience. If you believe in Wales, vote for Wales. As we approach May's election, those who believe in Wales must decide whether we want control of that destiny or whether we are content to let those who belittle us choose our future on our behalf. We can't trust Labour, bereft of values and conviction. We can't trust them to stand up to Westminster. But as a Westminster party, through and through, why would they bother? Wales deserves a party that stands up for Wales. All of us who believe in Wales, let's vote for Wales. Let's turn Wales into a home we can all be proud of.